Thank you very much. I would like to begin by thanking my esteemed colleague, Dramos Lucci, Speaker of the Albanian Parliament, for the initiative to host this important gathering. I am honored that we are joined today by Prime Minister Edi Rama and Secretary of State Mike Pompeo. I am also honored to be joined by my colleagues, David Sassoli, President of the European Parliament, Vjoza Osmani, Chairwoman of the Assembly of Kosovo, Aleksa Becic, President of the Parliament of Montenegro, and Talat Jafari, President of the Assembly of the Republic of North Macedonia. I would like to thank each and every one of you for your willing to discuss this critical subject. Albania has a long history of standing firmly against anti-Semitism, and it is no surprise that today it has taken a leadership role in fighting this phenomenon. We all remember the bravery and sacrifice of the Albanian people during the Holocaust, and especially the effort of the 73 Albanian Righteous Among Nations. By sheltering their neighbors and refugees from the worst expression of anti-Semitism in history, they made Albania the only country in Europe to have a larger Jewish population in 1945 than in 1939. Decades have passed, and we might have hoped that the lessons of those dark times would ring loudly in our ears and resonate to the present time. Sadly, we would be mistaken. Indeed, anti-Semitism has never vanished. It has merely flourished in new forms. Today, anti-Semites can hide behind delegitimization and boycott of the State of Israel, behind so-called social justice movements, and behind false arguments of political correctness. Others do it explicitly by glorifying the very Nazi ideologies that brought humanity its most shameful and tragic period of history. It happens not only in the darkest corners of the internet, but also even in the open. I think we must ask ourselves honestly, how did we get here? And what can we do about it? As Speaker of the Knesset, I believe that parliaments have a vital role to play in that aspect. We need to use all the tools available, legislation, discussions, promoting educational programs to stop hate speech and anti-Semitism. And we must urge wider adoption of the ERA working definition of anti-Semitism. I'm privileged to extend my appreciation to the Albanian Parliament, which just last week voted unanimously to accept this important document. I hope the message of this vote will inspire other countries and parliaments in the Balkans and around the world to adopt this definition as a statement of shared values and the call for a decisive action. Dear friends, I am addressing you today from a new Middle East, one that is radically different now than it was just a few months ago. The Abraham Accords that have been signed between Israel and the United Arab Emirates and Bahrain, joined by the declaration regarding peace between Israel and Sudan, have begun to bring down walls of suspicion and ignorance and replace them with cooperation, trade, and tourism. I hope that greater cooperation with friends, both new and old, will bring increased knowledge and lower levels of anti-Semitism also in our region. Distinguished leaders, anti-Semitism is not just a Jewish problem, but also a sign of deeper ills. Racism, hatred, and violence that accompany them do not stop at one people. Today, these are Jews. Tomorrow, these are others. We have the responsibility and the power as leaders from around the world to fight anti-Semitism, fight racism and hatred. Standing today, united, is a model of cooperation. From here, we should call on our colleagues and on the citizens of our countries. Say no to BDS. Say no to discrimination and double standard towards the Jewish state. Say no to anti-Semitism. Thank you.